Well, hello there. You might be wondering what this is, but you might not, because you might have read a title, or a description, or both. Or maybe you saw something that you recognized. But, this is not going to be a programming tutorial today, because I honestly don't think I'm that good of a programmer. I just think I'm better than 90% of people who are on beyond.com. It doesn't mean that I'm good. I think I still have a lot to learn. I think I'm well on that path of learning, but I do know for a fact that most of the people on Beyond who claim to be programmers are very, very lacking in talent. They can't do a tenth of what I can in a day. It would take them a week to fuck up and give up on what I have done in a day. Okay, so today, instead of being cocky brash asshole like in the intro, I'm going to be showing you some interface help. Childs. I want to be showing off childs. Children. It's not childs. Childs doesn't. It isn't the right. I want to be showing off the children panel. Or is it panel? The children control in Beyond Dreammaker. So let's go ahead. Just name everything tutorial. I'm not expert on Beyond. I do not claim to be. I do not want to be. But yeah, I'll just fucking do this. Fill window, and it'll fill up the entire window. Auto set the anchors. I'm leaving this as a window for now. And chat one and chat two. Now I'm gonna explain this the best I can. Chat one, what a child does is separates two windows and compresses them into one, giving you the option to move them back and forth. So chat one, I'm gonna make that an output that say you want several outputs for the combat information and the chat information. Well, this is how you would go about doing that. Not exactly. There are multiple ways you can do it, but if you want both of them visible and both of them separate for whatever reason, I personally think that's a bad idea. But if you want two windows put into one so you can move it around, let's say you have you have your map, and then on the other side you have your output, and you want to hide your output, there's a couple ways you can do this, but children are probably the best way to go about it, the easiest way to go about it, especially for beginners. Now, here you have to decide if you want a vertical splitter or a horizontal splitter. I'm going for vertical splitter. And this can be explained right here, left/top window ID, right/bottom ID. What it does is the window name you put here will be the window on the left or the top. It will be left if this is unchecked, which is a default. It will be top if this is checked, which is what I am going to do. And you make it whatever color you want. It doesn't matter. I'll make it yellow. Yeah, I'll just choose that yellow. I'll make mine yellow. Or I'll lock it. I won't even lock it. Splitter, percentage, top pane, left top pane. This just makes it how much percentage of the space is located to the first window that you put in. For instance, this one is chat one, so this would be 50%, which would leave that with 50%. If you put 40%, that would make chat two 60%, which would mean it would be 20% larger than chat one. It's just the space allocation is the splitter percentage, and you can lock the splitter to either the right/bottom or left/top, window one or window two. I'm just gonna call it. And with this, you can just swap which ones go where in case you fuck up in your code or something, and you just don't feel like rewriting it, or if you just fuck up in your skin and you don't feel like going through and renaming everything, you can do this. But I'm gonna leave it like that for now. Okay. Okay. New window. Edit window one. This will be chat one. Okay. And I'm gonna make output. Output one. Fill window. Anchors. Auto set. Options. None. Appearance. I'll give this one blue. Everything's gonna look a little fucking flamboyant, but I don't care. This is just so you can see it, and there's no, hopefully, no misunderstanding. And I'm gonna edit the window again. I'll make this a pane. And I'm not gonna explain panes this video. I might explain it in some other video. But I had someone I was helping out ask me a lot about children and a lot about panes. So I'll go through children first, and then I'll go through pane some other day. Options. This one is going to be pane two. This one needs another output. Output two. Anchors. No, I need the fill window and then set anchors. This one will just be red. No, because the thing's pink, so this one will be. No, the thing's yellow, so yeah, red. This one will be red. Okay. And for the chats, this one's output two. This one's output one. If you have a default checked on one of them, which I think, no, I don't have a default checked on this, but you had default checked whenever you send a text message to the player via the I don't know what it's called here. If you send there, I'll just fucking check it here. See output operator. You just send it to a user through this, to a list or a mob client through this. It will send it to the default. You do not have a default, I don't think it will output it. What you want to use when having multiple outputs is the output proc. So you use it like this. You can use the help book for a lot of things. I recommend reading through it if you are a novice with Beyond and just seeing what you can do with the system. And a lot of what you can do isn't in the help book, but that will get you started on the basics. Then I recommend going on the website, reading tutorials, and so forth. So that's if you're a beginner, and Codeatomy.com always helpful for people looking to get into programming. I'll make a video about that some other day. But output message control, you just gotta remember the window name, which is chat one and chat two, and the output name, which is output one and output two for this. That's if you want to use this example. I'm just explaining how you can use that. I'm going to compile and run. And as you can see, I have the chat window here and the other chat window here. I love that. This actually looks pretty nice. But you have a splitter in the middle. I'm pretty sure I checked vertical, didn't I? Didn't I check vertical? Yeah. Why is it not vertical? Run. What? What? I might have to report that because that shouldn't be right. I don't think so. Works right for DA though. Huh. Anyway, so apparently I had that mixed up and backwards, but I think I liked it better out of the way anyway, so I'm gonna switch it back. Oh, vertical splitter means the splitter is going up and down, not left and right. I don't know why that's like that, but yeah. So you can put like your battle outputs on the left or your chat outputs on the right, and then you can put your the opposite on the on the opposite side. Did I say the left side was the right side? I don't know, but the child allows you to do this. And I'm uncertain on the capabilities of a child. As I've stated, I'm not a professional on Beyond. I don't know everything about Beyond. I've only used it for about a year and a half, and I didn't go through tutorials. I didn't read the help book. None of that. I'll reference the help book every now and again just to clarify what something does or what order to put stuff into a proc. But I never sat down, read through the help book. I never read through tutorials. Everything I know is self-taught, self-learned about Beyond. And right here is what I use for Dragon Ball Z DA, and I'll put that in the video showing off what I did with children in that, and I'll show you my skin and the children I have in that. But you can hide one window, you can make one window smaller so you get more information from the other window. It just gives you more versatile skins, really, and this is really what it was used for, what it's meant for. It's not meant to do amazing things. If you want something custom, you're going to have to program it yourself. You're going to have to make HUDs and stuff like that, or pop-up windows and HTML and whatever have you. And this is a simple way, easy way to do it. Beyond is made to make things easy for you. You can make games in one day on Beyond. You can make games in one day on pretty much any platform, really, but you can make a game in literally an hour on Beyond. It's not going to be a great game. It's going to be really simple. It's going to be really shitty, but you can make a game an hour on Beyond because they provide the tools to make this simple. Make it simple. It's really easy. You just have to get over that small little learning curve at first. I don't mean to insult people who don't get it, because I'm, I guess, a bit of a genius. I learned things really quickly. I got on it like that. I come from making a calculator and a stopwatch in Java at my sophomore in high school. And that was it. That was all I got to do in that class because of technical issues and just laziness on the teacher and all types of things that went wrong in that class. All I got to learn was how to make a calculator and how to make a stopwatch in Java. I go from doing that into a completely different language and taught myself everything I know about the language, and I consider myself better than most of the people on Beyond.com as a programmer, not as an interfacer, not as a icon artist or whatever they like to be called, graphics or some people say, and it's just random titles kids give themselves. But I'm definitely not a composer. That's the one thing I have no talent in. I mean, I can play instruments, but I have no talent in that. I'm rambling on, and you don't need me to ramble on. I've completed a tutorial, so see ya. Okay, this is I'm back onto the Dragon Ball Z Dark Apocalypse skin, like I said. It starts out, and of course, there's a child right there on the main window. That is not important. Browser 1, this is the browser. Chat 1, this includes the output. Chat 2, this includes the inputs and the secondary output. Child 1, this is the secondary child. Child 2, third child. And child 4 is the fourth child. Of course, the first child and main child is in the default window, Dark Apocalypse. Then map 1 has its own window, and stats 1 have its own window. So you can switch it all out. I'll go ahead and there, I'll just join the game. This is Beyond's new beta, which they say is going to be public soon. I recommend checking it out. It's worth it. As you can see here, actually, as you can see here, they have a full listing of all games that haven't been banned from the website. So anything that wasn't told by Funimation or Square Enix that they cannot have on their website is listed. That includes Dragon Ball Z games like Dark Apocalypse. But here, I'll show you the skin. Of course, I'm the programmer for this game. But this is how I have my skin set up. You can alter what have you, whatever you want. I have the only thing that's really attached to itself, to where you can't alter the different parts, is this: the inputs, the secondary output, and the command bar. You cannot switch that around. So you have a big ass input or a big ass secondary output. You can stretch it like that though, if you want it, if you really want it that big. And of course, you can hide the rules if you don't like the rules. I don't blame you for hiding rules as long as you follow them. I don't think anyone's going to care. And you can hide your chat if you don't want to be disturbed and you just want to look at your techniques and be able to use your techniques, or just want to be able to check your stats. Of course, I'm edited because I test shit. I don't really train, as you can see. I don't train a lot. I train some. You can check your statistics if you like. You can do whatever. Look, Logo Chess from my other video. But you can do whatever. You can hide everything and just have your map. So it's pretty much like, I guess, kind of full screen your game without having the full screen. It's still in windowed mode, but the map takes up the whole screen. And this is lovely with the ASW movement. And if you like to make your own tech, like macros for your own techniques and stuff, it's great. And of course, I'm in a admin area, so you guys can speculate with that. So I don't care. But you can hide your that if you're just interested in chatting. You can hide those and just use this as a chat room. You don't have to play. You can just chat, which I hate, but I understand people like to use Beyond games as chat rooms. So if you like to just chat, there you go.